Hello, everybody. Welcome back. So for today, we're just going to pick back up where we left off and continuing the flight. In the previous episodes, we have been doing a bunch of touch and goes, working on my landings. And so now for this segment of the flight, we're returning back to Addison, and we're also doing some night flight. And so interesting to look at that. And then again, typically, just continuing to document my journey on becoming a private pilot, and at this stage, preparing for my stage one solo by really focusing on getting these landings down. All right, without further ado, let's pick up where we left off.
You're using your ailerons because you think it's going to turn you on center line? Nope. It's your rudders.
Yeah, tail.
There you go, good. You were like this close. You were so close to getting it right on. You know what I mean? You just added too much, and then we ballooned, right? So you added the correct amount of back pressure initially, but then you really yanked it back, and that's when we ballooned out of ground effect and slammed into the ground. And then what even worse is we just went, and then you lowered the nose, and we didn't have any energy, so then we came down like that. That's okay. That happens a lot in this, because you're trying to understand pitch and power, right? Uh-huh. So that's going to happen. Direct. Enter, enter.
Tail traffic, that's 441, rolling 36. Tail.
All right, let's go to Addison.
Cooler traffic, Archer.
Let's turn direct. So aviate right, navigate, communicate.
Okay. Yeah, that's a big thing that you'll see my instructor constantly repeating. Aviate, navigate, communicate. And basically, it's just keeping track of the multitasking priorities that are taking place. So when we're in the plane, it's one big multitasking endeavor. And to remember what's the most important thing to do is always to aviate, which is fly the plane. Making sure you're not too high, too low in your altitude, making sure you're going on the correct heading. That's because not communicating on the radio, that may not really necessarily lead to a fatality or mid-air collision, but not actually flying the plane will. And so it's just to remember your always priorities to aviate first, navigate, make sure again what direction you're headed to. Knowing where you are and where you're going is the next thing that's the most important. And then lastly, talking to air traffic control tower. You know, one of the things I'm screwing up sometimes is I'm focusing on talking to tower first and not thinking about, hey, wait a minute, I need to fly the plane. I'm losing my altitude. I need to get it back up. Or, hey, I need to remember where am I at? What direction am I heading? Because it's easy sometimes. You can easily wander off into the wrong heading. And so it's constant repetition that he's been preaching to me. AVA, navigate, communicate.
Tail traffic, Archer.
2,500, right?
Box shot is crossing.
Because we're going back to Addison, 2,500 feet.
2,500 will be a right teardrop.
Oh, yeah.
1,134.
So I gotta climb more.
Not 2,000, 2,500.
Oh.
And I like how you're at VY right now. That's good.
What would you change? Switch?
This dimming is all your lights here.
Oh, well.
You also have this up here. So now we're not in the travel pattern, right? So we don't have to pull the power back to 2,100. We can leave it at like 23.
Yeah. Navigation light on, because it's night. Landing light off.
Now, aviate, navigate, communicate.
Oh,
so fly the airplane first. Yep. Yep. I know. So really good on the ground effect, right? Getting into ground effect, that's the biggest challenge for you.
Okay.
That's when you flare.
When do we call for
radio? I would call now.
Huh?
I would call now. Because I'm almost on the edge of the Bravo here.
1000. Temperature 14, dew point -2. Altimeter 3024. Visual approach in use. Landing and departing runway 34. All VFR arrival status in contact. Regional approach on 124.3. For IFR clearance to VFR flight following, contact ground control 121.6. All IFR prop departures advised tower, you are IFR. Advise on initial contact, give information, Yankee. The tower information, Yankee, time 2347 Zulu, weather observation, wind calm, visibility 13, sky conditions clear below 12,000, temperature 14, dew point -2, altimeter 3024, visual approach in use, landing and departing runway 34, all VFR arrival status in contact, regional approach on 124.3, For IFR clearance to VFR flight following, contact ground control 121.6. All IFR prop departures advised tower, you are IFR.
Regional approach, thrust 551. We're 21 nautical miles southeast of Addison, inbound to Addison with information Yankee.
So, a couple of interesting things in here. I made a mistake not providing my altitude initially when I called regional approach. And so basically with regional approach is just a traffic, it's a frequency that when we're coming inbound, some airports have them, some airports don't, but we can get information before we actually transfer over to tower for a towered airport. And so as you can see, one thing I'm learning is sometimes when I don't make the radio calls correctly, I kind of like overreact. But one of the things I'm learning recently is that if, you know, you don't make the radio call as precise, they'll just let you know, hey, verify that you actually have information or verify your altitude. And they're usually nice about that.
November 6 Delta Delta, climb and maintain.
So that took a bit long, right? So okay. He has jets he has to do, so he's like.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, you're good. Okay. That's all
right. Squawk flight 551, squawk 4632, and verify your altitude.
And then what he gave us back was our squawk code. So the squawk code that they give us back from regional approach is basically a 4-digit code. In this case, it was 4632. That's our code that we put in. That is a code that identifies us on radar. So that in the air traffic controller, they're gonna be looking out for planes and different things like that. And that code is what helps identify who we are.
Squawk 4632, and we're at 2,500.
November 5026 Alpha, contact Fort Worth Center 13202. Sully 7, flying 1900 to maintain 2,500.
You're good, just listen to the radios. Okay.
Yep. 190, fly, descend to main 2,500, Sully 7.
Thrust 551, radar contact 5 miles northeast of Mesquite Airport, clears the Bravo VFR 2,500.
You get that?
Glenn November 2500, thrust 551, proceed to radar.
Flex jet 133, contact approach 125.2.
So just make sure you're listening, right? It comes out fast, right?
Oh, okay.
Thrust 551, traffic 1 o'clock, 2 miles southbound, that's kids 3600.
Have him inside, thrust 551.
Did you have
that? I have him inside.
Oh, okay, yeah, I see it, okay.
Because I want you to watch how my nose, because on final approach, when you're coming in, you tend to come in a little nose high, right? Really, you should be like this on an approach angle.
Okay.
You should be like nose down coming in.
Okay.
Because we're coming in kind of like this, and that's why speed's getting slower and slower and slower. And then we basically, you're hearing a stall horn on short final. So really what you need to be doing is, you need to be flying it into ground effect. So coming down, power to idle,
seven,
and then straight level. You're gonna fly straight level over the runway, just like you just like you did on the low and over.
Okay.
And then you're gonna start slowly and smoothly adding the back pressure.
Okay.
And transitioning into a flare attitude. So the round out and the flare are two separate things.
100 Lima Charlie, climb and maintain 7.
Two separate things.
7000 Lima Charlie.
So I'll break it up.
November 0 Lima Charlie, contact regional departure 126.47, 2647.
2647, 0 Lima Charlie, good day.
November 415 Romeo Juliet, descend and maintain 3000.
Descend and maintain 3000, Cessna 5 Romeo Juliet.
Now remember, aviate.
November 8212, 8212 Papa, squawk 4636.
4636, 12 Papa.
Scully 7, you're 2 miles from Porter. Descend and maintain 2,000 until establishing localizer clear the outlet, runway 34.
It seems easier to see traffic at night than it is in the day.
Roger, just maintain 3,000 feet for now.
It's also sometimes harder to spot airports because of all the myriad of lights.
Yeah, this is hard, yeah. Scully
7, contact Addison Tower.
Because, so what you're going to look for is called an airport beacon.
Airport beacon.
Yeah, it's a rotating green.
LL8, climb and maintain 4,000.
It's a rotating green and white beacon, okay?
Okay.
This is also important information that he just pointed out. And so, airport beacon is a rotating display of flashing white and colored lights. It's basically what we use at nighttime to locate the airport. And so, like he said, in this case, it's the rotating white and green light. at Addison, but it could be something else. And so this was actually kind of hard for me to notice where it's at. Oftentimes what actually would is helping is the fact that we're using GPS in this case, which you use on a majority of our flights. In some cases not, and then course, when I start getting to other stage two and three, you won't be allowed to use that, but we'll have flights on that later. That was really crucial to know that. So this is my first time really trying to, for this particular airport, trying to locate that.
Thrust 551, contact Addison Tower.
I'm just going to reduce the power to about 2100. I'm not necessarily letting the airplane fly me, I'm flying the airplane, right?
Addison Tower, thrust 551, just confirm clear to land, runway 36.
So now I'm coming in on final, flaps 3.
When the runway gets big, that's when I start the round out, right here.
Slow and steady, it wins the race. Take your time, you got this.
Elevation, it's one step, two step elevation. Keep growing, yeah, just keep on pacing. You're a creator, keep on making, yeah, keep creating.